Yo, what's up guys, Complize here. So today's video is going to be something that a lot of people have been asking for in my Twitch chat. I'm just going to be going over my autoexec and giving that to you guys. Now what this is going to do is it's going to lower a lot of the settings that you can't change by yourself in the game, which in return is going to give you slightly higher FPS, slightly lower input lag. It's going to make your game look a little bit more clear. There's going to be less visual clutter. Now this is a huge autoexec that's compiled with so many different commands. So obviously some of them are going to be outdated. I don't know which ones exactly, but there is going to be a lot of them that still work, as I notice a pretty big difference in FPS when I have this on versus when I just have the game on its regular default settings. So before I get into that guys, please remember to like, comment, and don't forget to subscribe if you enjoy the content. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you don't miss any more future videos. Links to all my social medias are in the description below. But most importantly, be sure to follow my Twitch where I stream Apex just about every day. But that's it for that guys, let's get right into the video. So real quick before I show you guys how to do this, I just want to show the difference between the two in terms of FPS. This isn't necessarily the best test. As we're just sitting in the range, there's not really too much going on. So if you see, I'm hovering usually about 190. Sometimes it'll jump up to 200, but for the most part it's slightly above 190. But as you can see with the auto exec enabled, your FPS is going to be a little bit higher. For the most part I'd say it's averaging about 210. It's jumping from about 200 to almost 220, so that's already a roughly 20 FPS increase. And this isn't even best case scenario, this is just a very simple demonstration, but it does go to show that it does work. Even if the difference is minuscule for you, it is going to make a difference. All right guys, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go down in the description and click this link that'll take you to pastebin.com, and this is where all the auto exec commands are going to be located. So all the way have to do is copy this and paste it into our autoexec, and to do that we're going to click raw. Now what we're going to do is we're going to hit Control A, which is going to select everything, Control C, or you can right click and hit copy, whatever you want to do. Make sure we have everything selected. Now we're going to go into our game files and find where our autoexec is located. So the easiest way to do this is to click on Steam or Origin, whatever you're using, right click, go to Properties, Local Files, and Browse. So once we're in our game files, all we do, we go to CFG. A lot of you already have an autoexec created, a lot of you won't. So in order to make your own autoexec, I'm going to go ahead and delete this and show you guys how to do it. So all we have to do is we have to copy our config default. We'll hit copy, and then we'll paste it back in. So we hit paste, then we're going to right click it, go to rename, and all we're going to do is just rename it to autoexec. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to double click and go into that. We're going to hit Control A to select everything, and then we're just going to delete it. Now at this point, you might have to go back into the paste bin and recopy it. It's really easy, all you do, right click, copy. And this is where you paste all of those commands in. So from here and all the way up are commands that will affect your video settings. It's gonna lower a lot of them, which in turn might make your game look slightly worse. But like I said before, it's gonna increase your FPS, which is the most important thing. And from here down are my audio settings. Now I know a lot of people like these. I've had so many people come into my chat and say good things, but there is a small percentage of people who have had nothing but problems with this. If you want more info on it, I'll leave a link to that audio video in the description below, but I'd still recommend you guys try them out. If you don't like them, all you have to do, you just come in here, delete them, and then that's it. Move on with your day. However, I like them, so I keep them just like this. There are a couple of new ones that I've added since I released that video, but if you guys are still curious, go ahead and check that out. Now, this isn't the end-all be-all of video settings. Sure, it's going to make a little bit of a difference, but it's not going to be game-changing. However, I'd still recommend anyone looking for any advantage to do this. But just remember that increases in performance are going to be different from person to person. Some of you might notice a 1 or 2% increase, while others might notice a 10 to 20%. It all depends on your computer, your specs, so many different variables. But at the end of the day, I'd still recommend everybody do this. And also, in order to get the full performance out of this, you should be playing on all low settings anyways. I'll be saving that one for another video when I do my updated settings guide, but you guys should always be playing on low settings. The only one that I recommend turning up a little bit would be textures, because that doesn't make too much of a difference. But other than that, everything lower off. So that's just about going to be it for this video. Links to the autoexec commands will be in the description below, as well as the audio video if you guys want a little bit more detail about that. Also, if you guys are playing stretched res, you'll have to change this matte letterbox aspect goal to 1.6. Mine's just on 1.77 because I'm playing native right now. But if you're playing any 16:10 aspect ratio, change both of these to 1.6. And also feel free to delete this one up top, CL FOV scale. I just have this in here because a couple of times my Apex has reset my FOV. No clue why it did that. So I just have this in here as an extra layer. So hopefully that doesn't happen again. But anyways, guys, that's going to be it for this video. I really hope this can help you. And if it does, please remember to subscribe, like the video, and comment as well. Hit that notification bell to make sure you don't miss any future videos. Check out the links to all my social medias in the description below. And I know I say this all the time, but please be sure to follow my Twitch where I'm streaming Apex just about every day now. We are full time now, so I need all the support that I can get from you guys now. And to everyone who already does support me, thank you guys so much. I really do hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Peace.